बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। हेयर लाइज द फेलोपियन ट्यूब एंड यू कैन सी दीज आर दी फिम्ब्रिएटेड एंड दिस इज द इनफंडिबुलम, दिस इज द एम्पुला एंड देन देयर इज एन इस्थमस द नैरो पोर्शन एंड देन इंट्राम्यूरल पार्ट ऑफ द फेलोपियन ट्यूब विच इज पासिंग थ्रू द वॉल ऑफ द यूट्राइन कैविटी। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द फेलोपियन ट्यूब्स, दैट इज द यूट्राइन ट्यूब्स और ओविडक्ट। The uterine tubes or oviducts conduct the ova from the ovaries to the uterus, and they also provide the necessary environment for the fertilization of the ovum. The wall of the uterine tube is composed of three coats, from inside outwards the mucosa, muscularis and the serosa. You can see the mucosa is thrown into the longitudinal folds throughout the length of the tube. In the ampullary part of the tube, the folds branch in a complex manner to divide the lumen into a labyrinth of spaces. This is the ampullary part. The mucosa consists of the epithelium and the lamina propria. All of you know the epithelium is of simple columnar variety. Some of the epithelial cells bear cilia at their free luminal surface. The cilia beat towards the uterus and are believed to play an important role in the transportation of ovum through the fallopian tube to the cavity of the uterus. So mucosa is lined by the simple columnar epithelium, then is the lamina propria, which is the loose areolar connective tissue, and mucosa is characterized by the longitudinal folds. As regards the muscular layer, there are two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal layer of the smooth muscle. The outermost covering is the serosa, and this is actually the visceral layer of peritoneum and consists of loose connective tissue which is having the simple squamous epithelium, which is called mesothelium. So you can see that in the oviduct there are two types of epithelial cells. They are non-ciliated PEG cells. They have got no cilia. These are the secretory cells. They have got the secretory granules in the cytoplasm. They are nutritive and protective for the oocyte. Then we have got the ciliated cells. Cilia beat towards the uterus. You can see the cilia. So it is the peristaltic contraction plus ciliary activity and fluid which moves the oocyte and the zygote towards the uterus. This is the diagram which can Here you can see the transverse section of the uterine tube. This is the serosa. This is the circular layer of the muscles, the longitudinal layer of the smooth muscles, the lamina propria, and this is the lumen of the uterine tube. And you can see these columnar cells. And these columnar cells are of two types. There are ciliated and there are non-ciliated cells. The non-ciliated cells are called the PEG cells, which are nutritive and they gives nourishment to the oocyte. So this is the simple columnar epithelium which lines the uterine tube. And mucosa, I have told you, mucosa is having these folds which are longitudinal folds. So this is the cross section through the uterine tube.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Let's start with the histology of the uterus. The walls of the uterus are three, that is endometrium, myometrium and serosa or the adventitia. Endometrium, if we talk about the endometrium, endometrium is the innermost layer and it is actually the mucosa which consists of the epithelium and the lamina propria. Epithelium of the uterus consists of the simple columnar epithelium and there are ciliated cells and there are secretory cells. And if we talk about the lamina propria, it is composed of loose connective tissue which is rich in fibroblasts. There are reticular fibers and there are uterine glands which are simple tubular. The epithelium dips down, invaginates into the lamina propria to give rise to these simple tubular. Some of these glands are simple tubular branched. The microscopic structure of the endometrium changes during the menstrual cycle So we will try to study the endometrium and its structure according to the changes in the menstruation. If we talk about the endometrium, it is again, it is composed of two layers, or there are two zones, the zona functionalis and the zona basalis. The zona functionalis is the thick superficial surface epithelium and the lamina propria, and also the glands which are lying in the lamina propria. This is very rich in the capillary network. There are coiled arteries present. And this is the zona functionalis, is the portion which is sloughed at the time of the menstruation, which is sloughed off at the time of the menstruation. If we talk about the zona basalis, this is deep, narrow. This portion just below this dotted line is the zona basalis, and this consists of the deep, narrow lamina propria and the glands. There are straight arteries in it. It regenerates the functionalis layer after each menstrual cycle. Myometrium is the muscle of the uterus, that is the muscularis. Thickest layer of the uterus, it is composed of three layers of smooth muscles. There are inner longitudinal, there are middle circular, and there are outer longitudinal muscles. The size and number of the muscle cells are related to the estrogen levels. In the pregnancy, the hyperplasia and hypertrophy occurs. I have told you in first year MBBS that the longest muscle, the smooth muscle, is of the pregnant uterus. That is, it can attain a length of 500 microns, which is usually 10 to 100 microns in length. But in the case of the pregnant uterus, the hypertrophy and the hyperplasia of the smooth muscles takes place, and it will attain a length of 500 microns. Under the stimulus of estrogen and progesterone, endometrium undergoes cyclic structural modifications. And these modifications are, there is a proliferative phase, there is a secretory phase, there is a menstrual phase, and there is again proliferative. This menstrual cycle is of 28 days, and it starts from the puberty up till the menopause, that is about 45 to 50 years of age. All the females, they have got this cyclical change every month, which belongs to the females only. And this menstrual cycle, its duration is 28 days. What happens in the proliferative phase, which is from day 5 to 14? Let's start from the proliferative phase. The proliferative phase, it starts from the fifth day of the menstruation, and it then extends up till the 14th day. After the menstrual phase, the proliferative phase coincides with the ovarian follicle development. That is under the influence of estrogen. There is regeneration of the endometrium up till the day 14. The fully restored surface epithelium, the lamina propria, and the coiled arteries. The uterine glands, the simple columnar epithelium, and the straight tubules. Next is the secretory phase, that is the luteal phase. It extends from the 15th day of the menstruation up till the 28th day, and it begins after the ovulation. Ovulation, you know, it occurs at the 14th day, that is the middle of the menstrual cycle, and it depends on the corpus luteum secretions. If the pregnancy occurs, the corpus luteum, it remains as the corpus luteum gravidarum. Otherwise, the corpus luteum develops for the next 9 to 10 days, and the progesterone is the hormone which is secreted by the corpus luteum. And what happens in this secretory phase? The uterine glands become coiled and branched, and they become big and large. There is accumulation of glycogen. The lumen is dilated, And in this way, there is the thickening of the functionalis layer, that is the zona functionalis. There is oedema and there are secretory products present. And this is prepared to receive the zygote. This is the preparation of the uterus to receive the zygote. एक मेहमान को जो है वो मेहमानदारी के लिए तैयार किया जा रहा है. यूट्रस को एक मेहमान की मेहमानदारी के लिए तैयार किया जाता है ल्यूट्रियल फेज में. देन फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट डे टू द फोर्थ डे देर इज अ मेंस्ट्रुअल फेज. देन देर इज नो फर्टिलाइजेशन. इफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन डिडंट अकर Corpus luteum degenerates and there is drop in the progesterone and estrogen levels and the coiled arteries constrict, and because of the constriction of these arteries there is ischemia and necrosis of the functional layer, and later on there is rupture of the arteries and there will be hemorrhage and bleeding starts, and this is because of the shedding of the functional layer of the endometrium. The basal layer remains viable for restoration of the functional layer later on.